Dear students, today we will discuss about CPU architecture philosophies. So in the previous module, we were discussing about machine instructions. Those were stored within the computer RAM and those were fetched by the CPU. So for stored programs, CPU are designed to recognize those instructions. Those are called machine language. Those are written in the machine language. And each instruction or step is known as machine instruction. And then there are two philosophies which we will be discussing, that how to design those machine level instructions. So machine instructions are basically quite short. Once basic level is met, adding more machine level instructions does not adding anything new into the theoretical capability of computer. Rather, it is just a convenience that what you want to achieve. So then there were two type of architectures which were proposed and being used even today. So first of the CPU architecture philosophy is RISC. So RISC is reduced instruction set computer, and it should exclude minimal set of instructions. Should execute minimal set of instructions and machine, so that machine is efficient, fast and less expensive. So the people who designed this kind of RISC architectures, they said that there should be very limited instructions, and those instructions should execute minimal set of instructions, and with this machine should be efficient and very easy to use. However, there is another philosophy that says we should have complex instruction set computers, and this complex instruction set computers, they argue that CPU should be able to execute large complex instructions even they are redundant, no matters. And the more complex CPU can cope with the ever increasing complexities of the real applications. So if we compare both CISC and RISC architectures, in 1900 and even in millennium, both architectures were competing to take place for desktop computers. However, the RISC was quite easy to implement and CISC was quite expensive, and Intel processors developed for PC or CISC complex instruction set, and PowerPC developed by Apple, IBM and Motorola using RISC architectures. However, with the passage of time, the cost to build CISC architecture computers reduced, and Intel processors are being used virtually in PCs, in laptops, and even Apple is using Intel at the backend today. So this means all of such computers are using now the CISC architecture, that is complex instruction set computer. So which says even then there are redundant instructions, you add all of the complex instructions so that your computer can perform well complex task efficiently. And then what happens with the RISC? So RISC is also being utilized by company known as Advanced RISC Machines. Utilize RISC for low power consumption areas, for example in game controllers, in digital TVs, in navigation systems and in smartphones, where we need low power and we do not want to consume lot of power, and the size of the computer within such kind of system is very small. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned CPU architecture philosophies, and there is CISC and RISC complex instruction set computers and reduced instruction set computers, and we have learned why they were developed and what is being used for what purpose nowadays.